Hey there, guys. Welcome back to Let's Play Mega Man X8. Last time, we basically just started the game, and I didn't even get to save my progress yet, so we're gonna do that and save over my old save file. And, continue as a result. And the first thing we're going to do is go to the chip development area and develop some chips. Not potato chips, but, basically, this is the store, and the main reason I am doing this on a save file that I've already completed the game once on is because this way I can fully upgrade everyone's health right away and don't have to worry about all my characters being super squishy for the majority of the game. The reason I wanted to do this is because, this game can be kind of difficult at times, not supremely so, but a little bit. But either way, I managed to build up enough medals that I can buy most of the upgrades, not all of them, right away. Most of the upgrades, not all of them, because I didn't grab that many on previous run-throughs, but enough that I can make the game a little bit easier for me, and that's what I... Look, I don't like games that are super difficult. I'm not really a big fan of really hard games. This series is actually probably some of the hardest games that I've actually managed to beat. How hard? I actually managed to beat X6 relatively recently. But, yeah, just gonna buy a bunch of stuff here. You may notice there are a decent number of upgrades that are missing, and that's because one of the systems of this game is the rare metal system, where you have to find these things called rare metals, which allow you to unlock more upgrades. There's also a chip delete function down there if you want to delete an upgrade for whatever reason, but you don't get the metals you spent on that upgrade back, so doing that may not be advantageous for you. Anyways, this formula is the same. Go after the 8 Mavericks, and we're gonna start with this guy, Gigabolt Manowar. And I'm gonna take X and Axel because this stage has no platforming involved. Now, there's supposed to be a cutscene involving the introduction of these three, but I guess because I played through this game once already, and I'm using a previous save file, they're not giving me that cutscene, so oh well. Anyways, this level can actually be kind of a pain in the ass on normal and higher, which of course it would be because it's a ride chaser level and everyone loves those. The basic premise is shoot this guy enough times that he crashes and burns. Burns the ground even, maybe. But, unfortunately, on normal, this can actually be a pain in the ass, because this guy... actually catching back up with him if he gets too far away can be a utter pain. And, that was me right there trying to check the controls for a minute there, because I couldn't remember how to boost here. Okay, there we go. Also, you may notice he's, making some rather weird noises. That's mainly because in the Japanese version of this game, this character actually apparently speaks English. Like, really poor, like, broken English. And for whatever reason, they left his lines in this chase sequence untranslated. They bothered to give him proper voice acting in the cutscenes. So I don't really know why they didn't bother giving it here. Anyways, these purple medals will give you a lot of medals if you can collect those. What was that, 400, I think? The red ones will give you 100. And I honestly don't know the value of the yellow ones. Pretty sure the blue ones are just one. I do like this level's setting, and I do like the music a decent amount, even if it does kind of sound like circus music. But this level itself is just kind of a pain, because actually catching this guy is such a pain in the ass. You can see he's smoking now, which means that he is somewhat close to being defeated. I don't even know what he's saying, to be frankly honest, and I don't think I want to know. Also, I've never had it happen to me, but I know that if you let him get too far, it will count as a death. So, don't let him get too far. And I'm out of boost. I don't know what those are actually called, so I'm just gonna call them boost cans. I know they're not cans, but I don't care. Okay, got him. Alright, now moving on to the actual, fight part of this boss fight.
Warning. Warning.
I'm only now realizing how much this is really reminding me of Episode 2, Attack of the Clones.
Return Megalopolis' energy supply to normal. If you don't, the city will be destroyed. Has the change to Maverick even caused the loss of his speech capabilities?
I'm no Maverick. Who are you, anyway?
I'm X. I'm a Maverick hunter.
Anyways, Gigabolt Manowar. He's not very difficult. In fact, none of the bosses in this game are particularly so, with one kind of exception. When I first played through this game, I, like several other instances where I first played the game, I looked up which Maverick should I do first, and the forums I found basically said, honestly, do any of them, because this is one of the easiest sets of these guys in the series. Anyways, on normal and up, once they get to a certain level of health, these guys will start using their desperation attacks, which are these, for Manowar is this one, which is just this big electrical burst thing. I'm explaining it really badly, but anyways, we get close enough to him, I can hit him with a double attack. Which, since we have the gold background, means we are going to be finishing him off with that. Take this, jellyfish. I know technically Manowars aren't jellyfish, but they're jellyfish enough that I think they count. And whenever you finish a level, you get a pretty decent number of medals. I think maybe 1,000. I don't know, I didn't exactly count there. You unlocked Plasma Gun, Thunder Dancer, Raikusen. I do like that they brought back the demonstration of what the weapon does for everybody, which they... I don't think they've had that in the series since X4.
That looked like a hard fight, but there was never any doubt that you'd come out on top.
Also, thankfully, the developers were nice enough to not put any unlockable items in that level. That would have been horrible. Oh, right, I'm playing this cutscene here because I was gonna go back to another level before this.
That's right. It's begun again. How long must this war go on? Just the thought of wiping the floor with those Mavericks makes my trigger finger itch.
Axel!
No, Aelia. Axel's right. There's no time to be wishy-washy here. Even as we speak, Mavericks are causing havoc.
Well, we will continue next time.